Welcome to the old boar plays City Skylines. Sometimes you need to make changes to your map. I'm talking about the textures, the color, the roads, the space that's below the houses. This is your gravel texture. This is the texture that's in front of buildings. It's also the pavement texture. And you can see that we have what they call grass sprites. And so we're going to make changes to those. I loaded my game and found out that the map theme creator had changed the theme. And so I installed Theme Mixer 2 to take care of this. So the first thing I don't like about the new map theme change is this road texture and the gravel texture underneath the houses. This is also your gravel pedestrian paths. You can also change some of the lighting. One of the things that I really like about this theme are the mountain textures. It's quite yellow, but we can fix that. This is the best texture for mountains that I found on the Steam Workshop. The Crown Mountains theme, which is what I originally used, is now called Crown Mountains Old. There's a newer version, and the mountain textures are not quite the same. So let's open up the theme mixer and get started. So I've installed one other theme, Praria. These come with the Theme Mixer 2. And what Theme Mixer 2 is, it's just a mod that allows you to mix between any themes that you want. So let's start with the cliff texture. We definitely want the Crown Mountains theme. You can see it's already selected, because the map loaded with this theme in it. This is the grass texture, and before we do that, we will disable grass sprites and fertile sprites. You want to see what rock sprites look like. These are rock sprites. I'm not fond of those, so I'm going to disable it as well. So once you click grass texture, you're going to get the themes that you've subscribed to. This is the Praria grass texture. It's nice. Boreal, European, temperate, tropical. I'm going to stay with the Crown Mountains theme, grass texture. Next is the gravel texture. Crown Mountains is selected here. You can see that it's a bright yellow. One of the things that we should do at this point, if you're using Daylight Classic, you want to decide whether you want your classic sunlight intensity enabled. I'm going to go ahead and do that. I had to leave it off before because it was too dark. Now that we have the Theme Mixer 2 installed, we can adjust some of the lighting settings. So now we're back to gravel texture. Let's see what the 4K Praria looks like. It's all a matter of personal preference. I like this one the best. once you're back in this menu, you can also change the texture tiling to be more granular. This is more granular. And the further you move to this end of the slider, you can see that those textures become really big. The rocks become really big. To reset it, this is the reset button, and leave it like it is. That changes the bases of the houses and any gravel pedestrian paths that you lay down. The pavement texture, which is your sidewalks and your bases underneath your commercial industrial buildings, we're going to do that after we change our roads. So we'll come down to this little icon here, structures. This is the road upwards texture. This is the Crown Mountain theme road texture. Let's see what this one looks like. And we'll check these others out since we're here. Keep in mind that you'll need to keep this map theme subscribed to in order to continue to use your theme mix. We're going to brighten up our game here in a minute, so I think I'll stay with this. Now we'll go back and we'll look at the pavement path texture and we'll match it. I like the CO's European theme. Before we move on too much, we're going to go to Atmosphere, and you can see that we can control the longitude and latitude and the exposure. And I'm going to go ahead and use the classic sunlight intensity with Daylight Classic. So I'll increase the exposure just a bit. I'm going to try to get it back to where my game was before. I'm also going to put these at zero. Put the number in. Hit enter. I like to put the longitude and latitude at zero because then I can see all the way around my buildings, pretty much. Now we can see much better the road texture, the pavement texture, and your gravel texture. So if you were to come here and click any one of these, this is your top button, you're going to revert back to all the changes that are built into this map theme. If you just load a map theme, you're going to get whatever that map theme creator gave to you. Your lighting settings, longitude, latitude, exposure settings, etc. I'm pretty happy with all of these. Of course, you can play around with this. You can even change the color of some of these. RGB is red, green, blue. You can give it a red tint. Now let's take a look at our water. This is our water texture for Crown Mountains. You can see it's highlighted in blue there. So let's see. This one's slightly different and gives us the reflection of the clouds a little bit more. There are more waves in this theme. And it looks like all of those are the same. At this point, if you wanted to change the color of the water, you can do that here. If you wanted to make it more blue, I'm going to move this little plus sign up and down. And you can reset it back to normal. There's also an underwater color. But I'm going to reset it the way it was before. I'm happy with it. Water foam, you need to see a river or a waterfall in order to be able to look at those. These white waves are your water foam. I'm going to stay with the Crown Mountains theme. If you unpause your game, you can see that foam. So I'm pretty happy with all my settings, colors, etc. This is the weather tab. You can change the probability of your rain and other weather effects. Now this is the color correction. We're using clear and bright, but you could change your theme color correction here in game if you wanted to. During this process of getting my map back the way I wanted it, I've gone through probably 50 different map themes and 30 different color corrections. And so I eliminated all of the others, and I kept these two themes to use in my theme mixer. So now, one of the last things that you want to do is you want to save this mix. I've already saved it here, but let's just say you wanted to call it Remote Japan. You'll hit save, and then in order to see it in the drop-down, sometimes you have to come out and back in order to see it in the drop-down. So I'm going to use Remote Japan, and I'm going to save this as my default. If you were to change anything now, let's just say we went back to just the Praria theme. This is the Praria theme. Mountain textures are pretty good. And let's load the other color correction. And let's increase the exposure just a bit. The latitude, longitude. I basically changed almost all the aspects about my game. You might be saying to yourself, wow, I wish he would play with that theme. Again, it's all a matter of personal preference. This is probably more realistic to the island that I'm creating here. But I just want to see bright colors. I want to be lifted up every time I load my game. So, we go back to settings. We drop down to Remote Japan, and we load it, and we're back where we were before. So that's how to make your colors and your textures perfectly the way you want them to be. So one other thing that you need to do, save your game and come back into the game and go to your content manager and come down to mods. You need to type in here the name of your theme mix. You see that I have Remote Japan here. I want to enable that inside my content manager. Well, thank you for watching the old boar play City Skylines. Take care now.